Hey friends, Chris here with Through the Prism of Chrism. We're excited to have you with us today. We're airing from the auditorium of Teen Challenge Mid-America here in Cape Girardeau, Missouri, where we've been having a wonderful time with Spiritual Emphasis Week. And we're continuing to speak from my little mini book, The Model Prayer, on the Lord's Prayer. And we come to that clause today that says, Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Now, it's not about church, it's about kingdom. A lot of people are concerned with my church. But get your mind off church for just a minute. Get your mind on the broader view of the kingdom of God. You know, this part of the prayer is what examines our motives and self-will and so forth. I've seen the way people act that they're praying, hallowed be my name, my kingdom come, my will be done in heaven as it is on earth. You've never actually prayed it like that, but you've thought it like that because we all have things that we want. Well, James 4:2 says, you have not because you ask not. And then verse 3, and when you do ask, you ask amiss. Or in other words, you ask with the wrong motive, that you may consume it upon your lust. So it's important that we come into the secret place, shut the door, and then examine our lives to make sure our priority is right. Now, I'm talking with a capital P today, priority. Your kingdom come. That is my priority. Everything about my life is kingdom oriented. This prayer is theocentric. It is not egocentric. It is thy kingdom, not my kingdom. It is the oriented. And not me oriented. And I think it's important that we get that right, that the king is first, that we're subjects to the king, and what the king says, go. Listen, an absolute monarchy is the best form of government only if the monarch is perfect and reigns in perfect love. Well, God is love, and we're under the monarchy of his kingdom, and that's the best government, the government of God. Praise the Lord. Now, look at three things on this. This prayer, thy kingdom come, first of all, says something about our faith. Luke 17:21 says, the kingdom of God is within you. Amen. I'm in the kingdom. The kingdom's in me. I'm bringing the kingdom to men. I'm bringing men to the kingdom. Praise God. John 3:2, it says, except a man be born again, he can't see the kingdom of God. A lot of people are unable to see what God's up to because they've never had a heart change. They've never been born again. Matthew 18:4 says, except you humble yourself and become as a little child, you can't enter the kingdom of God. So this says something about my faith. The fact that I'm humbling myself to realize that I am a dependent of the king. Second, it says something about my family. Because listen, I'm not just a subject to the king. I am a son of the king. And that makes me royal. You too. Why don't you turn to somebody right now and say, glad to see you today, your highness. Do you realize that if you're in the kingdom and the kingdom is in you, then you are a king's son. He's king of kings. What's that mean? He's a big king. We're little kings with a capital K. We reign in life. It says in Romans 5:17 that we are to reign in life through one, Jesus Christ. It says a lot about my faith. This prayer says a lot about my family. And third, it says a lot about your and my future. Do you realize when we say thy kingdom come, we're praying about something that is yet to come. Right now, the kingdom of God is around us. The kingdom of God is in us. But we haven't seen the kingdom of God established on this earth. But soon, that's going to happen. Jesus is coming back again. It says in Revelation 11:15 that the kingdoms of this world are become the kingdoms of our God and of his Christ, and he shall reign. Amen. Jesus is coming back. Check this promise out in Revelation 12:10. Then I heard a loud voice saying in heaven, not voices, voice. When the church comes together with one voice, this is what's going to happen. Now. How many of you are waiting for it? Now. Kingdom now. Now is salvation and strength and the kingdom of our God and of the power of his Christ is come, for the accuser of the brethren is cast down. One of these days soon, Satan's power is going to be knocked out of the heavenly realm, and the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords is going to come back and set up his kingdom. But do you realize every time we come into the closet and shut the door, we are seeking the priority of his return. Lord Jesus, come back. You know, the last prayer in the Bible ought to be the first prayer on our lips. John said in Revelation 22, he said, even so, come, Lord Jesus. Can you just say that right now? Thy kingdom come. Come, Lord Jesus. And whether he comes tonight or not, if he doesn't come tonight, be sure to tune in tomorrow for another two-day triumphant video cast. We'll see you then.